Good morning friends, I am going to show the demo how to retrieve data from MySQL table using the XAMPP server. To work with the XAMPP server, you have to download the XAMPP server from the website and you have to start the XAMPP server by clicking the XAMPP control panel. So this is the first step. Click the XAMPP control panel. So to work with PHP and MySQL, you have to click this particular start button. So to work with PHP, you have to start this Apache start button. And to work with MySQL, you have to start this MySQL option. Now both the service has started. To check whether the XAMPP is working or not, you just open the browser. So you type HTTP followed by localhost and abbreviation for XAMPP is Apache, MariaDB, PHP and Perl. So and you have to type your local directory or virtual directory which you have created. So let me show how to create a virtual directory. So by default the XAMPP is installed in the C drive. So this is my C drive. I have installed my XAMPP here. So in my previous video I have shown the video of how to install this XAMPP server from the website. So this is my C drive I have installed here. This is my XAMPP folder. There you have to find one particular folder called HT documents, that is hypertext documents. In that HT documents you have to create a virtual directory, so your working directory. For example, HT documents, I am creating a new folder called demo. So for this purpose I am creating the folder called demo. So demo is my folder. So I need to save my file here. So for example, when I want to work with PHP, so I am just typing the code. Either you can select Note or Notepad++, Notepad or Notepad++. So Notepad++ will make you, it will help you to work very easily with all the scripting language. So this is my Notepad++ editor. So I am just typing some code. For example, I want to type some code. So I am just typing PHP code, question mark PHP. Then after that, print. I am just typing some message, welcome to. Welcome to XAMPP. So close the double quotes and semicolon and question mark greater than symbol. So this is my PHP code. So welcome to XAMPP I am typing. Now where I have to save to work with XAMPP means, so go to the file option, go to the save option. So it is showing me XAMPP HTDocs Anand. So what you have to do is go to the XAMPP folder, go to the HTDoc folders, and there I have created that folder called demo. In that, and click that demo folder and type, this is my, so first program I am just giving some hello.php. So hello.php. So when you are working with Notepad++, you can just pressing, by pressing P, it will give the PHP file. See here, PHP hypertext preprocessor file, star.php, star.php3, PHP4, PHP5. You can even save as star.phtml. So save this extension, and you can give extension hello.php. So if you are mentioning the extension also, no need. So just click save. So to run your script, see, it is now changing the keywords. It is showing in a red color. You can see it here, and print. So it is showing in blue color. So this is the advantage of working with Notepad++. Now what I have to do is, I have to open this localhost, then followed by the folder name I have to give demo. localhost/demo means it will show the files which I have saved it here, and if I am clicking hello.php, it is giving the output welcome to Xamarin. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to show the demo how to retrieve the table or data from the MySQL table using PHP in using the Xamarin server. So what I have to do is, so you have started both the things, that is MySQL and Apache. Now what you have to do is, you have to go to the MySQL. So type the URL localhost, then you have to access your MySQL by typing the URL localhost/phpMyAdmin. So in Xamarin server, we use only the MySQL option. PHP MyAdmin is the option which is there in the graphical user interface itself. So PHP MyAdmin, if you are clicking, it will be directly go to that particular MySQL window. Here you have to type localhost/phpMyAdmin when you want to work with your MySQL. So now I am going to create a new database. So you can see all these tabs are here. So I am just clicking the particular thing called databases. I want to create the database. So I want to create a database with my name, Anand. So just click the create button. So already Anand is there. So I am just creating with another name. So I am giving demo one. Demo one is my database name. I am just clicking created. Database demo is created. So you can see here it is giving some kind of alert message. So no tables found in this particular database. So I am going to create a table called student, and it is also suggesting how many fields you want to have. By clicking this arrow, I can increase and decrease. So I am going to have 3 field for this particular table. Click go. Then after that, I am giving name, age, and department number. Name, age, and department number. So I have to give the data type. Name is worker, and age integer, department number worker. And I have to give the length. If you want to specify the default value, all these things you can give as it is. So just click, and you can also select the storage engine. So by default, you just leave InnoDB is your storage engine. Just click save. So when you are created the table, you can see the data type name, data type, and what is the other things you can see, attributes, default value, null, everything you can see. The table structure you can see it here. Then if you want to have some attributes to be added extra, you can have. For example, I want to add the particular thing primary key for this particular table means, so click this particular department number. I want to add this department number as primary key. So you can see the symbol here, the key symbol, it is added here in the department number field. That means it will not allow the duplicate value for the particular field called department number. So your SQL query has been changed, executed successfully. Alter table student, add primary key department number, that is make the department number as primary key. Now I have to insert the value, so just go to the insert option, give some value, Sanjay, age 18, so department number 18 UCA. ECA 10. And ARAM, age 18, and department number is 18 UCA 19. And you can click just go. If you want to add, so you can see here in the insert query, if you want to add some more value, just go to the insert option. So I am giving Tamil, 18 UCA, sorry, age 18, 18 UCA 35. So this all the values. Suppose you want to add one more, you just remove this ignore symbol and just click go. So if you are just select star from the table student, it will show the all the values from this particular table. Just click go. Now we have three records in this particular table: Sanjay, age 18, Aram 18, Tamil 18, and corresponding department number. So this is about your MySQL. Now we have to write the coding for your PHP, that is to select the data from the table. So what we have to do is, I have the program already, so I am just showing this program. Go to the XAMPP folder, so Z colon XAMPP folder, go to the HD docs. And in that XAMPP folder, HDocs Anand, this is my program. This is my select coding. So major difference between the XAMPP and XAMPP coding, all your MySQL function can be replaced with the keyword called MySQL. So lesson symbol, question mark, PHP, dollar link, or we can have dollar connection. So for example, this is my connection string, means I am giving dollar connection. MySQL underscore connect, it is a function which is used to connect your PHP and MySQL. Localhost is your server name. Root your username, that is the, in the root only we have created the folder called demo. Then password I am giving it as empty, and my database name, the last column is database name is demo1. So meaning of this particular line is, using the WAM server, using the root directory, that is demo, with the password, empty password, and with the MySQL database name called demo1, you select the table from the MySQL. It is used to establish the particular connection between PHP and MySQL using the XAMPP server. This is the meaning of that particular coding. If the connection is not established, so dollar connection is equal to false means die error could not connect. So die is the function which is used to throw the error message. So mysql_i_connect_error, which is used to give the corresponding error message why it is not establishing the connection. Then after that, it is attempting to try the SQL query. $SQL is equal to, so you know very well, dollar, it is meant for the variable name. Select star from student. So select star from student mean select all the values from the table called student. If $result is equal to mysql_i_query of $connection, $SQL. Using the first line, using the connection string which you have established between PHP and MySQL, so execute the MySQL query which is given here, that is select star from student. So this statement which is used to execute the query select star from student. And the next if statement, if mysql_i_number_of_rows of $result. So after selecting all the values from the table called student, the values which will be saved in a particular place called $result. This code has executed, select star from student, and the values will be stored in a particular variable called $result. If the result is greater than 0 means, so you are using the HTML tags here, echo table. So this is the tag which you are using, table tag, table row, that is TR means table row, then table header, name, age and department number. So this is going to create the table row with the following fields, name, age, department number. So table tag for table, creating the table, TR for table row, and one row it will be created like name, age, department number. So table row, after this is it is closing the table row tag. So while the result is always stored in a form of rows and column, while $row, $number of row is greater than 0 means if you are displaying this thing, while $row is equal to mysql_fetch_array of result. If the result is in the form of rows and columns, so it has to fetch one by one. Echo table row, first row, it has to fetch the name. Table data, TD is nothing but table data. In a first table data, it has to fetch the name from the database. Table data is closed. Then age, so it has to fetch the age. Department number, so it has to fetch the department number. So name, age, department number, it has to fetch for the first row, and table row is closed. Again, it will go for the second row. Again, it will display like name, age, department number. Again, third row. Again, fourth row. Until it is reaching the end of that particular file in a MySQL table. Then after that, so closing the table which you have created here, that is echo table, mysql_i_free_result_of_result, then else. So if you got the result, so it will display the result. Then after that else, if it is not finding any rows here, inge vandu result greater than 0, enna rows nu, it is not finding out any rows means, so it will write this message, echo no records matching your query. And second one is, if it is not able to execute the SQL command, This else part will be executed. Error would not able to execute the MySQL. So this is if the this particular line is not able to execute using the connection string $SQL, this else part will be executed. Would not able to execute the SQL command. So MySQL underscore error. So what is the reason for is not able to execute that particular query? So all places I have changed this link as connection. Even you can have it as link also, no problem. Then MySQL underscore I underscore close of $connection. In the first second line, you have established the connection. That connection should be closed in this particular line. That is MySQL underscore I, MySQL I underscore close of $connection. Then close the PHP tag by using the question mark greater than symbol. So now you have to select this particular code in a particular place called so XAMPP folder htdocs and demo is my new folder. I am saving this particular file as select.php. Select.php. And since it is notepad, you select the option called all files option. Just click save. Now what you have to do is go to the browser. So again you type http localhost and my virtual directory name is demo and I am having two files here and just click select.php. I can see the result. So this is the use of table tag, name, age, department number and correspondingly I am getting the result. So you can display the result in a proper formatted manner. So this is how we have to work with the XAMPP server for retrieving data using PHP from the MySQL table. So thank you so much for watching this video. Kindly give your feedback and comments. Thank you so much.